celebrates the commemoration of all the faithful departed of the All Souls Field. And we are here to pray for our departed humans. That is the most painful thing when it comes to our near and near ones. But it's a reality. On the other day, I was taking a walk in Cattle Course on the seashore, and I saw a bench facing the sea with a bouquet of flowers placed for someone whom they have lost. Some rites upon that. We really love you and miss you, Dad. I stood for a while looking at that bench and the bouquet. It reminds me of a day I had to offer. It reminds us of a day we had to. So when we pray for the dear ones departed, we pray for them and they are praying for us. At the same time, it's an occasion to remember that one day we have to. So that is enough for us to rectify our life. That brings us to evaluate all about our life. It's not. Then we think all these factories we're going to live in is all future.
This mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare Sabbath began to talk, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Everyone was filled with awe and praised God, saying, "A great prophet has appeared among us. God has visited his people." And this opinion of him spread throughout Judea and all over the countryside. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Wife, for their mother. And those times like that, focus our love for others, for those who have died and are awaiting that eternal life. And we can happily say that all the faithful departed have not gone from us because we keep them in our hearts and in our minds. Rather, they've gone before us. And one day we will greet them as well. Pope Francis visited the cemetery next to the Vatican, and he went round the graves and blessing them. And at the end of this Mass, we also will do something similar. And I'll give some more detail later on. But more than ever, let us remember that it is hope that we have. It's not our faith, it's not just a belief, it's our certainty that this eternal life to which we aspire, we will reach. It may be a short time, a long time. Nevertheless, it is there to aspire to. And as a final thought, the prayer that we have at the end of funerals, it's a song of farewell. I know that my Redeemer lives, and on that final day of days, his voice shall bid me rise again, unending joy, unceasing praise. And this hope I cherish in my heart, to stand on earth, my flesh restored, and not a stranger, but a friend. Behold my Saviour and my Lord.
To our all-knowing provident Father, raise our hearts and bring all our needs before you and say, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Church may be strong in her faith in the resurrection of the dead and diligent in prayer for those who have gone before us. Lord, in your mercy, that the example and leadership of our deceased leaders who honestly worked for justice, life and peace may be rewarded before God with everlasting joy. Lord, in your mercy, that as we remember today all those who have died, and still need the charity of our prayers for their purification and release, our intercession may be fruitful on their behalf. Lord, in your mercy. For all who mourn the loss of loved ones, especially the loss of children who have died, or those those who succumbed to natural disasters and violence, that the family's suffering may be eased by hope in a life to come. Lord, in your mercy, that the power of this holy sacrifice, by which Jesus released us all from the bonds of everlasting death, may free the souls of purgatory who are the most need of God's mercy. Lord, in your mercy.
Seeking the intercession of our Blessed Mother, we pray. Hail Mary.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the wine and work of human hands, it will become us the spiritual drink. Through him, the host of angels and all in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread to all the world, and bring back to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Robert our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may be also one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, Saint Vincent Paul, and all the saints who have praised you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I decide to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart, I embrace you as being already there, and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. through these sacrificial gifts which we have received, O Lord, bestow upon your divine servants your great mercy, and those you have enjoyed with the grace of baptism, grant also the fullness of eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our brothers and sisters have gone to their rest in the peace of Christ. With the love of the Lord, now welcome them into the chamber of God's children in heaven, with faith and hope in eternal life. Let us assist them with our prayers. Let's pray for the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brothers and sisters. Together, we may meet Christ Jesus, who is our Lord, and God comes to us in glory. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises of resurrection, even as it claims our own mortal bodies. Grant that our brothers and sisters may sleep there in peace until you awaken them in glory, for you are the resurrection and life. Then they will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
For our brothers and sisters, let us now pray to the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.
Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, in your mercy, you wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, in your mercy, you raised the dead to life. Give to our brothers and sisters eternal life. Lord, in your mercy, you promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring to all the joys of heaven. Lord, in your mercy, our brothers and sisters were washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give them fellowship with all your saints. Lord, in your mercy, they were nourished with your body and blood. Grant them a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brothers and sisters. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, in your mercy,